And when the Navy isn't marching them, it's dunking them. This grim little device simulates what happens when an airplane cockpit hits the drink. The pilot must stay calm long enough to extricate himself from controls and seat belts. There's a diver standing by in case the candidate panics and can't find his releases. This machine is even scarier. It tests candidates' ability to get out of a larger airplane that's sinking. They strap themselves in, take a deep breath, and... The challenge here is to follow orders, which are to do nothing until the craft stops moving. When it stops, and only then, the prospective pilots who are upside down can undo their straps and find the nearest exit, if they aren't too disoriented to find it.
Check this out.
First day since June for a student pilot at NAS Meridian to be in control of the T-2C Buckeye jet. 13 jets in prime condition are ready for takeoff. Some 70 planes are still waiting for a new part called the hydraulic actuator boost to be installed. This helps control the movement of the jet's nose. Commander of Training Wing 1, Captain Gene Smith, says the plane is good as new.
We're great. Very happy to be back in business.
Students will follow normal syllabus procedures, except for one hitch. No solo flights are allowed. Captain Smith also says the planes could have flown earlier, but weather held them back. Sarah Thrasher, News Center 11.
Shave my tree. I said, hold it on. Who me? Walk the down. Not my style, man. rock's out of the question. Sending weekend, up all night.
Members of VT19 today prepared a video that will be submitted for possible telecast during the annual competition between the two military branches. The frogs of VT19 wanted to get their game day yell just right, and they did.
Flight Training Squadron 19, and Meridian, Mississippi, set, go!
Ow! Right, I am
Take off, circle, spot your wingman, warm up, take bearings, head out. All this is happened by now.
We'll be right back. Okay.